Headaches are a big problem, but they are not just a problem for the person suffering from the headaches, they are a problem for societies at large. Each year, millions of people suffer from serious headaches that keep them from doing their job. In fact, according to estimates, headaches cost individual and business more than $50 billion each year. This is one of the reasons research into headaches has become a worldwide effort. Although he did not know much about how headaches work, Hippocrates was the first doctor to find ways to treat them. Before 400 species, Hippocrates discovered the bark from willow trees was useful to treating pain. He made a white powder from the tree's bark and gave it to his patient. Hippocrates did not know it, but he actually prescribing a natural chemical in willow's bark called salicin. When a person eats salicin, the chemical etches inside his or her body into salicylic acid. It turned out that salicylic acid is good for stopping pain, including headache pain, but it is bad for a person's stomach. In the 1800s, a chemist in Germany changed the acid from a little to take it easier for people to take. This new form of chemical was called acetylsalicylic acid, commonly known as aspirin today. Aspirin was used throughout most of the 1900s to treat headaches, but doctors had a little ideas about what really caused headaches. When doctors know the cause of a disease, they can find a better way to treat them. Therefore, as medical technologies developed, doctors began to use technology to learn more about the human brain and about headaches. Currently, doctors classify headaches into two general types, primary and secondary. A primary headache is a condition suffered as only headache itself. On the other hand, a secondary headache is one caused by another condition. For example, someone who catches the flu may suffer from headaches along with other symptoms of the illness. Flu headaches are third secondary headaches. For primary headaches, doctors have determined three possible causes. One kind of primary headache is caused by stress. Doctors usually call headaches of this kind tension headaches. Such headaches are characteristically felt on the both sides of the head as a steady pain. Another kind of primary headache is migraine headaches. Doctors believe that this headache is caused by reduced flow of blood to certain parts of the brain. A migraine sufferer usually feels instant pain on one side of the head. The sufferer also becomes sensitive to light and noise. If the migraine is severe, the sufferer may vomit repeatedly. The third kind of primary headache is known as crusher headache. Crusher headache typically occur around the same time each day or week or month, and at a time, the person suffering from this kind of headache usually feels pain on one side of his or her head, and the pain is centered around one of the person's eyes. Doctors do not know much about reason, but a reason about crusher headaches, but they seem more common among men and could be related to alcohol or other things that affect a person's blood flow. Using computers and more advanced medical equipment, doctors continue to learn more about what's happened in the brain before and during headaches, especially in the case of migraine. Some doctors believe they have found the parts of the brain that set up the reactions for serious attacks. With this new insight into brain process, Doctors hope new ways will be discovered to disable headaches before they begin.